Well, hello, cousin.
Guard!
I'm glad you're finally here. He's been asking about you for days. I had to sit through the same story 5 times.
We got here as fast as we could. And I like Grandpa's stories, especially the ones with dragons.
Ah, yes, the legendary beast that he set free. I don't know if he forgets I've heard that story before or he doesn't care, but he loves telling it to anyone that will listen. I'm pretty sure I heard the nursemaids telling his same jokes in the hall.
Have you heard anything the doctors are saying?
Yes. Doctors, wizards, magic elves. Grandfather is fine, Gwendolyn. They all say the same thing. He's just old. He still has a few good years left. Look, we're all excited that your family made the trip, but there's no need to worry. You should get some rest. I'm sure you're scheduled for a full morning of Grandfather's hilarious ramblings.
Oh, I'm also scheduled for the tournament tomorrow.
Ah, yes, the fencing tournament. You'll love it. I'm, of course, favored to win, and will make sure you have the very best seat to view my victory. The courtyard will be filled with important people and delicious hors d'oeuvres.
Oh, I'm actually competing in the tournament.
I had no idea we were hosting a junior tournament. That's incredible. In that case, I will gladly be there to cheer you on and eat delectable appetizers.
Nope. No junior tournament. I'll be squaring off against you.
I see. Well, perhaps this is the time to stop listening to stories and finally make some of your own. Good night, Gwendolyn. Sleep well.
Come in, Gwendolyn. You can set those on the nightstand.
Grandma said to take 3 spoonfuls of each.
I'll get to those. No need to fuss over me. Now, let's talk about far more important issues, like that fencing tournament. I hear you're competing.
Well, I signed up, but I'm not so sure anymore.
Nonsense. If it's Gart you're worried about, he's no bother. After all, I only learned that you entered after he complained about it all morning. Threatened, I'm guessing. There are many ways to win a duel. I, for one, have always been fond of... treating my opponents with respect. You'll be surprised what opens up to you. A lovely fellow once told me the fastest way to anyone's heart is through their stomach. Speaking of, that reminds me of a story. One I know you haven't heard before. When I was a much younger lad, before I was a knight, before I'd been to Daventry, and even before I'd seen a dragon. It's a tale about a tournament that changed my life. It is a long story, but I shall tell it briefly.
Well, Triumph, this looks as good a place as any to camp for the night. Let's rest up. We have a big day tomorrow.
After gracefully rappelling down the cliff, I welcome the sight of an actual road, the first sign of civilization. Daventry was just a few miles to the east. I'd read all about its wonders in my travel books. I couldn't wait to check out its famous fantastical floating island. I could have sworn the parade of hopeful knights was scheduled for the next day. I should have been with them, marching with triumph. It seemed my first few minutes at Daventry were off to a terrible start.
So, how did you catch up with them?
That odd horn seemed to be missing some sort of mouthpiece. Strange tracks blazed a trail through the forest. I wondered what those birds needed a toolbox for. Shame. The only tool left seemed to be a small hatchet. And no, Gwendolyn, before you start asking me thousands of questions about that hatchet, I did not go around using it on everything. That wheel seemed freshly broken.
Stand back, you dirty thieves!
Wah! Oh, it's just a boy. Don't know where he's from, but it must be hard to pronounce.
You know, you should never sneak up on a guy in a dangerous place like... No! What's wrong with your foot? Probably stepped on a spiniferous thornweed. Don't worry, I got just the fix for that. Tell me, is it more of a... Ow! Or a... Oh, oh! Either way, the Merchant of Miracles has got you covered. But it'll cost you. I've risked my neck to forge the most rare, miraculous, mysterious, and oftentimes delicious ingredients. Huh, here it is. I massage this into my skin twice a day, and just look at my little biscuits! Well, now that I've mulled it over, you'd better not. It might stunt your growth. Ooh, such exquisite material!
Hey!
Mm-hmm.
I knew you weren't from around here. Well, you best get going. Yeah. Nobody likes a late night. Oh, wait! You're stuck here with me. Every bridge in is out. And my shortcut had a few shortcomings. I swear that rock leaped straight out of the water. Now I'm stuck here with no wheel, a lost toolbox, and Mr. Fancy Cakes. Say, what? I'll bet a fine, strapping young man like you could help me fix up this wheel. Yep, you help me fix my chariot, and I'll give you a lift to the tournament. Hopefully no one else notices your horrible lack of punctuality. Oh, how rude. Do you have any questions for me?
Nope. Oh, can I pet your goats?
Stay away from my majestic unicorns!
Perhaps there was a wheel on the other side of that river. Too bad I couldn't swim.
How did you get across that river?
That missing wheel had me stumped. I had to go out on a limb to get past the root of the problem.
Ugh. Grandpa, your infamous puns are not my favorite.
What's the matter? You don't like the timbre of my voice? You'll warm up to the puns.
These are terrible.
Here, kitty, kitty. Not a kitty! Not a kitty!
No wheels in there. An overgrown patch. The spiniferous thorn weeds obstructed a path to the water well.
The well with the ginormous dragon in it?
Perhaps. I tried to chop down those thorn weeds, but my tiny hatchet was ineffective. I would need a bigger, sharper blade. Square was eerily quiet. Was I the only person in Daventry not at the parade? A bakery, and it smelled delicious. The delectable goods looked tasty, but I couldn't compete in this tournament with a full stomach. I didn't see any reason why that stale bread wouldn't work for a wheel. Like a blacksmith shop of sorts. I borrowed enough for the day. That sign was asking for tips, and there was a metal pan to collect coins. A shortcut.
Do I really have to hear the story about how you took forever to tiptoe across that fallen tree? Again?
No, I guess not.
I thought this might do the trick.
Lovely choice, boy. And thank the Yarblesnoofs, this bread is beyond stale. Hopefully it didn't pay too much.
You have a face that just screams overcharged. I've got just a fix for that, too. But we have important tournament business to tend to, and I think this'll do the trick. Ooh, I'll just need to start locking my unicorns up at night. Mr. Fancy Cakes has a nibbling problem. All right, off we go. Oh, wait, before my mind slips, I was able to procure an entrance ticket to the tournament. Since you so graciously found me a wheel, I am more than willing to sell it to you at a reasonably discounted rate. Are you interested?
Oh, sounds good. I love a deal.
So do I, boy, so do I. If I see one, I'll let you know. Here you are. Now, let's vamanoosie from this meadowland, Mr. Fancy Cakes. It is go time. Mr. Fancy Cakes! Heel! Halt! Avast! Stop! We sincerely hope you enjoyed your stay in our luxury cabin. Please gather your belongings and watch your head on exit.
Thanks for the hospitality.
No time to lounge, my boy. Lucky for you, the parade is halted. Another case of a mysterious missing bridge, I imagine. Watch your step. We wouldn't want any tears in that illustrious cape. Bon voyage, Buttercup. Don't forget about us working folk. Especially when your pockets are full of riches.
Back away, back away. This area is unsafe for commoners.
Hello. Apologies, I'm late. I should be on the list. First name Graham, last name...
The list, unfortunately, is inside the theater, which is across that bridge, which is inexplicably missing.
We've ordered a temporary fix, but we're still sorting out the work order.
Well, with all the recent budget issues, I remain skeptical about the repairs.
Well, can't those knights check the list?
Do you mean Kyle and Larry? They're off duty. Don't ask.
You needn't worry. These knight hopefuls will figure out a solution soon, and then we can carry on with the auditions.
Well, but I am a hopeful knight. If you just step aside, I'm confident that I could find a way across.
Ahem. Daventry Decree 6645 states that a royal guard, once commanded, must never, under no circumstances, abandon his post while on duty.
Well, technically, Addendum 237A allows us to leave if someone is in distress and in need of assistance, of a life or death nature.
I stand corrected, and we wouldn't want a repeat of the Rubenstern fiasco. A tardy auditionee, however, hardly counts for distress. Sorry, but we can't leave our post. King's orders.
Stay off those rocks. It's dangerous. Distress!
Abandon post!
Learn how to swim, boy.
Thanks for saving me.
You're welcome, lad.
He was talking to me.
I believe he was talking to me.
Nope, me.
Wouldn't be the first time I've correct...
The forest is blocked until this situation is under control.
Come at me, bees!
Stay off those rocks. It's dangerous. Distress!
Abandon post!
Learn how to swim, boy.
Thanks for saving me.
You're welcome, lad.
He was talking to me.
I believe he was talking to me.
Nope. His tired argument is getting on my nerves.
No need to argue about the fact that I am...
Uh-oh.
Okay. Not good.
Another horn and another missing piece.
Mind if I join your semicircle?
Let us big kids figure this one out.
my bow is brand new, so it still needs to be broken in.
Where did he get a bow? Did I miss the part where we got bows? Pardon me!
You can't ignore me forever.
I don't mean to be rude, but I'm deep in thought.
The tree was too heavy to move. I would need to chop it down to size.
Hang on a sec. Graham, right?
Yes. How did you know my name?
Well, you'd be surprised at the information people give out when they're too busy thinking about their own agenda. I also observed that without you, no one could have made it across. Well done, Graham.
Thanks, I guess.
They'll never acknowledge it, you know. Those who use their minds over their biceps are never woven into the tapestries of time. I can tell you're like me, a creative thinker, an intellectual. To win this competition, you'll need to prove that your talents are more powerful than their strength, agility, and speed. You'll also need a friend.
I could really use a friend.
They call me Manny. Pleased to meet you.
So, friend, what's your favorite color? Do you like popcorn-flavored jelly beans? Because I do. What's your availability for sleepovers? Are we in a secret club?
Green. I prefer pizza flavored. I'm free on Wednesdays and Saturdays, and I would say more of a secret alliance.
Alliance?
This competition will not be easy, and Daventry needs men like us. If we put our heads together, we might have a shot.
What's the plan?
If you win, put a good word in for me with the king. And if I win, I'll do the same. Soon, we'll both be moving up the ranks in the castle together. We should head inside the theater, though. Let me know how I can help.
Another horn and another missing piece.
Graham, to the front of the stage, please. Now that we have recovered our list, it is my duty to inform you that you are officially signed in. Yay. And I do want to apologize. I am very, very terribly sorry. But we've run out of commemorative tote bags.
That's not a problem. I have no use for tote bags. My mother designed my cape with lots of pockets. Is the next event about to start?
Not so fast, Pocket Boy. The tournament bylaws explicitly state that each contestant must complete every event before continuing on in the competition. Since you were late, you missed the test of chivalry and the welcoming parade, both designed as lighthearted warm-ups and getting-to-know-you type exercises. You know, an icebreaker before we start in on the usual death, destruction, and duels of a cutthroat nature.
Don't forget about Amendment 70, Article 4.
I was getting to that, thank you. In the spirit of equal opportunity, the new rules state that you can schedule a makeup chivalry test if and only if the circumstances for your absence were extenuating. So, I will ask, what were your extenuating circumstances that made you late for the tournament?
Well, I never heard the date was switched.
Mm-hmm. I'll just pencil in hard of hearing. Now, go on, mingle with the other contestants. Find out as much as you can about them, and when you're ready for the chivalry test, come and see me.
Hey, thanks for knocking that log over out there. Really, it gave me the opportunity to go on a lovely cruise.
Those nights were annoying me, and I wanted some alone time. Leave me be, little fly. You don't want to wake the bull.
Look, I don't want to be in this conversation any more than you do, but I missed the chivalry test, and I need to make it up. The faster we get this over with, the faster I can leave you alone.
Well, make it quick, then buzz off.
I'm Graham. Graham
Cr- No. No last names. I don't even want your first name.
And your name?
I'm known throughout the land as Circumference, but I am currently in the process of rebranding myself, starting with my name. You should call me Acorn.
What was that you were hiding in your paws?
Well, none of your business, Feather Boy.
I'll leave you be.
Go away!
The treasure that was within. I could feel the riches with the edges of my fingertips.
Hey there, I'm Graham.
Charmed, I'm sure.
And your name?
What?
Well, I didn't catch your name.
What? Is this true? Surely you jest, Greg. What rock did you crawl out from? How do you not recognize this well-proportioned face?
Well, it's not Greg, it's Graham. And of course I know who you are. You're... Sir Ten of himself.
Cheeky. But now you're starting to bother me, Grant.
I couldn't help it. No, but seriously, you're... That jerk who pushed me into the river.
Oh yes, that silly feather does look familiar. Look at it. Like a limp piece of cheese. What you need, Gale, is an upgrade. Like my mane of excellence.
Hey, my mother gave me that feather. I might be silly, but you're... Every woman's dream?
Well, you got that right. The ladies love. Ooh, yeah. Who do they love, Gabe?
It's not Gabe, it's... Oh, never mind. Yes, your name... You're... Going to have to wait one second. I'll be right back.
I'll be waiting right here, Garrett.
Hello, my name's Graham. Nice to meet you.
Achaka.
Good chat. I'm gonna get back to the chivalry test.
Oh, hey, Graham. We were just sharing some tips about the tournament. Let me know if you want the rundown about any of our competitors.
What can you tell me about Acorn?
I can tell you not to mess with those bull horns in any strength competition. I shouldn't be telling you this, but I heard a rumor that the man keeps a pet squirrel under his belly. What kind of a weirdo does that? Imagine what else he's hiding under there. Neither of us is going to be able to match his strength. If we're going to oust him, we'll need to work together and expose his secrets.
What can you tell me about Achaka?
I'm studying his every move. He should make any opponent quiver. You got me doing it now. He's fast, strong, and vicious with his bow. I'm trying to convince him to join our alliance, but the translation isn't quite working.
What can you tell me about Sir Ten of himself?
That's so inconsiderate. Although clever, these silly puns are Not very becoming to a gentleman like yourself. Go meet everyone, then come talk to me. I've got a few tips to share.
I'm good. Thanks, Manny.
Goodbye!
Unearthed the treasure that was within.
You see this one, little fella one?
What do you want?
I heard what you're hiding.
No, you didn't, skinny pants.
I did. I heard a rumor that a tiny squirrel pet lives under your belly.
What? Who told you that? I bet it was Whisper. He's the worst. His ego is the one thing I can't stomach. And she, well, she's not my pet. She's my friend.
Does your squirrel friend have a name?
I wish Whisper would keep his big mouth shut. Her name is Princess Madeline of Avalon. She's a proper lady.
What else is hidden in that belly?
The bones of a feather boy if you don't leave me alone.
I think you're hiding something else in there, but I'm not sure I want to find out. I'll leave you be.
You need to get lost.
Unveiled itself.
Yes. Have you remembered my name?
Whisper.
Correct. Well, Whisper's full name is Sir Walter Harris Ignatius Sally Percival Eduardo Ramon Jr. the Third, hailing from Modesto. But I'm sure a fan like you knew that. Would you like an autograph?
Huh. I don't seem to have any portraits on me.
Well, if you find one, I'll sign it. Free of charge. Whisper loves his fans. Whisper loves the knighthood. Whisper loves thwarting evil. But most of all, Whisper loves Whisper.
As do we all. I should be getting back to my chivalry test now.
Don't go! Whisper can do it!
That's a nice thought, but I'm pretty sure those guards would never confuse you for me. I mean, your armor is pretty recognizable.
Whisper's armor is shiny, because Whisper loves his own reflection.
Yeah, I get it. Good day, Whisper.
Are you ready for the chivalry test?
Let's do it!
Question one. Who is the only knight competing in the tournament that speaks multiple languages?
Manny. We're friends, you know. We have kind of an alliance. Next question.
All right. Next question. This knight hopeful hails from a land far outside of Daventry. Based on the odds, he is favored to win the competition.
Achaka.
Okay, moving on. What is the full name of the fastest contestant in the competition?
Sir Walter Harris Ignatius Sally Percival Eduardo Ramon Jr. the Third of Modesto. I'm sure of it.
I see. Last question. Who or what is the favorite companion of the strongest competitor?
Princess Madeline of Avalon. She sounds quite charming.
Okay, let's see here. Tallying. It looks like you got all the answers correct. Great job, Pockets. Now, we shouldn't keep your new friends waiting, should we? Let's